theta with this, and here this minus and this plus, this becomes minus, and we are having cos theta sin phi, cos theta sin phi, and this is in J unit vector. So cos phi curly by curly theta and minus sin phi cos theta in and curly by curly phi. So this is in J unit vector, plus there is no k there, but here we are having k. So this minus in this minus becomes plus, and h bar over I, and then sine theta cancels with sine theta. So we are having curly by curly phi and in k unit vector. So I can write that this is actually our Lx, this is our Ly, and this is our Lz, because we know that this vector L here is Lx in I plus Ly in J and plus Lz in K. So we have found that Lx is equal to h bar over I and minus sine phi curly by curly theta and minus cos phi cotangent theta minus cos phi cotangent theta and curly by curly phi. So here I have written, this one is common from this h bar over I. So curly by curly theta is with this, and then with the cos phi we are having minus sine phi phi curly theta. Yes, this is right. So we will have to write this one is, here I have missed curly by curly phi. So here is curly by curly phi. Do that correction. So here is curly by curly phi. And similarly, Ly is equal to h bar over I and cos phi curly by curly theta, cos phi curly by curly theta, and minus sine phi cotangent theta, minus sine phi cotangent theta, and curly by curly phi. While Lz is equal to h bar over I, because we are having h bar over I curly by curly phi. So we have found the components of angular momentum. Now we will have to find the L plus minus, the raising and lowering operator as well, which are equal to Lx plus minus Ily. Now as we have proved that what is Lx and what is Ly, so it is just their addition, and I can write that it will be equal, the L plus minus will imply, so let me write it here, L plus minus is equal to h bar over I And from here, I will write minus sine phi and plus minus, because curly by curly theta, I will have to take is common. So h bar over I is common, it is here. Minus sine phi and cos phi curly by curly theta with a plus minus. So it will be minus sine phi, and this plus minus will come in, and plus minus I times cos phi and curly by curly theta. This will come in, and let's take this one as a whole common, because h bar over I is all of them minus, and here I write cos phi plus minus I sine phi and multiplied with cotangent of theta curly by curly phi. So look here, that this one is then in the curly brackets. Look here, when I will go to the next term, and the next term is in Ly, in Ly we are having the next term, so we will have minus cos phi cotangent theta I have taken is common, and curly by curly phi is common. So minus cos phi here, then plus minus in I, and then here is sine phi. So I have written sine phi there, because minus is here and minus is here. So sine phi and cotangent this, while the minus in minus will make this thing like, let's look for the sign Lx. So it is minus cos phi, it will come like this. Here this one is minus, and here is another minus here with this, that plus minus. So it will be, we will keep this minus and plus minus we will write here. Now as I know that cos, I know that cos theta, or let me write this in x, cos x plus I sine x is equal e I x, the Euler formula. So if I write plus minus here, I will have to write plus minus here as well, and then I can write this is the, in compact form, L plus minus will come out to be equal. What is this? Actually, this is the same, this I will write is E plus minus. This I will write is E plus minus I phi. Now when I do multiply this I here, so this is minus sine phi. If I write this minus is I square, it will become I sine phi. What about this one? I will cancel, and plus minus will remain. So cos phi plus I sine phi. So I can write this in a compact form, that plus minus h bar and e plus minus I phi, then curly by curly theta will remain, and plus minus I cotangent theta curly by curly phi. This is the compact form of L plus minus. Now, we will also require to have the value of L plus into L minus, means their multiplication. And this is done, you will have to practice, because this is just algebraic simplifications. 4.21a problem, and this can be proved that L plus minus is equal to minus h bar square, and curly by curly theta, and this is squared, so curly square by curly theta square plus cotangent theta and curly by curly theta plus cotangent square theta and curly by curly curly square by curly phi square plus I and curly by curly phi. So this is the multiplication, and we will have to write now L square in terms of these, because the relation we have already proved that this is L square, and L square can be written in terms of L plus L minus in LZ. So by following that relation, one may solve in the problem, the same problem, but the D part, that this L square is equal to minus h bar square and 1 over sine theta curly by curly theta sine theta curly by curly theta plus 1 over sine square theta. And this one looks very similar to the equation that we have already done, is an angular equation. So this is our L square, and now we are in a position to apply L square on our eigenfunction and get L into L plus 1 h bar square and our eigenfunction. And when I do this, then this is equal, the L square FLM is equal to minus h bar square 1 over sine theta curly by curly theta, and minus h bar square is common, 1 over sine theta curly by curly theta and sine theta curly by curly theta plus 1 over sine square theta curly square by curly phi squared. And this is on FLM, and this is equal to h bar square L and to L plus 1 FLM. And we can easily recognize that this is actually our angular equation, which we call the Legendre equation. And this angular equation is the one that we solved earlier. And if I write for the LZ, when LZ operates on FLM, it gives ML and H bar FLM. So put the value of LZ here. So this is equal, if I put the value of LZ, then this implies that LZ is h bar over I curly by curly phi FLM, and this is equal to ML h bar F Lm. And if I look to the previously solved Schrödinger equation, the phi dependent equation, so this was the azimuthal part of the angular equation. The azimuthal equation. We have seen here these equations, but we have already solved the angular equation, which was the Legendre equation without azimuthal symmetry, and this is this one with m equal to 0. This is the azimuthal equation. We have already solved them, and we came to know that the solutions of these equations are actually the spherical harmonics theta and phi. So it means that while solving those equations, we have not only found the eigenfunctions of the Hamiltonian, we have also found, inadvertently, we have also found the eigenfunctions of L squared as well, which are L into L plus 1 h bar squared psi, and also the eigenfunctions of Lz, which are Lz equals ml h bar and psi. So here our FLM came out to be the YLM, which are the spherical harmonics. So this is theta and phi, and we have already solved them. But there is one problem, and the problem is that when we solved the angular equation or the azimuthal equation, we got only integer values for L. But here we proved that L can get integer values as well as half integer values. And this is quite startling, that why this difference is coming in. So to resolve the half integer